when we look at care of the dying and the last number of months of patient's life, generally speaking, there will be a gradual decline in what they're able to do. And so what we call their functional or their performance status, their ability to do things, to care for themselves, will decline. And, you know, at some point you are bedbound, you can't eat and drink, and you may go into a coma and die. So looking at the changes in functional status is an important thing for nursing care. You know, how much, what kinds of care do you need to allocate, etc. And early in my career, in the early 1980s, in looking at people dying, this kind of was ringing a bell, because people would want to know how long someone might have to live, you know. And I'm trying to size up how to prognosticate. And one thing was, well, people decline, and if we can measure that in any way, that might be helpful for prognosis. And we didn't have the internet back then, but in looking at the cancer field, they were using a scale called the Karnofsky Performance Scale, or what would be called KPS. And I liked it. One reason, they're using it in the cancer field. But secondly, it had what I was thinking of, which is this gradual incremental change. So somebody at 100% is healthy, no disease, everything is great. And in 10% increments or decrements, down to 0% being dead. And so there's about 10 levels of decline, and that seemed quite logical and good from my point. So I liked the Karnofsky mainly, but I didn't like it at its lower level, what we would call KPS 30% or 20% or whatever, because what it was saying there is that they're very sick and hospitalization is necessary. Well, our program, we were dedicated to, well, we did have a palliative care unit, but we're dedicated to helping people at home and supporting death at home. Not everybody needs, just because your performance function declines doesn't mean you need to be in a hospital. But KPS was kind of suggesting that. So what we had done was to create then a modification of the Karnofsky scale in changing some of those parameters that were so that they were functional, but not telling you where that care needed to be. And then we added a couple of other things about declining intake and a few other things. So it became a modification of the Karnofsky.